problem, an escalating war between the president and members of his own party. There is a new statement for the president attacking the chairman of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, Bob Corker. Strange statement by Bob Corker. Corker questioned his stability, considering that he, Corker, is constantly asking me whether or not he should run again in 18. Tennessee not happy. And then there is a statement from the senator, former senator from Missouri, John Danforth, a scathing criticism of the president. Joining me now to discuss, CNN national security commentator, former chairman of the House Intelligence Committee, Mike Rogers. Mr. Chairman, thank you so much for being with us. The president's got this feud now with Bob Corker. Bob Corker questioned whether or not he was stable. And the president today made this statement on Twitter where he revealed the contents of a private conversation, apparently, that he had with Senator Corker. You know, as someone who has served in Congress and has worked, you know, on behalf of the president back during the transition, would you be happy to have your private conversations aired now for the public?
It's exasperating. If you really want to try to do some of the things that I think people wanted Donald Trump to do, when you talk about infrastructure improvement, when you talk about tax reform and tax relief, when you talk about the big picture of getting health, some free market ideas back into the healthcare debate, all of that seems to be lost on this president, and it's just shockingly bad. You cannot poke the people who are going to have to vote and write and debate and amend the bills going through that to support your agenda. It makes no sense whatsoever. Think about where they were, Bajan, when Obama came in and he had, he owned the House and the Senate in big numbers, and he came out to do something that he really didn't talk about a lot in the campaign, but he did Obamacare, and he did that because he knew he had a short window to do something he wanted to do. This president, I mean, has put on the boxing gloves and just started whacking away. It will stop his ability to get his agenda done, and I don't know why he doesn't understand that.
And there is this new criticism today from a different front, from the former senator from Missouri, John Danforth, highly respected within the Republican Party, who wrote a scathing op-ed in the Washington Post. Just one of the lines he said was that our party has been corrupted by this hateful man and is now in peril. I have to admit, I was surprised by this level of vitriol from Senator Danforth, an ordained minister. What do you make of it?
Listen, I've given up being surprised about Donald Trump. I mean, if you think about the fact that he gave a relatively presidential speech on Afghanistan and then goes to Phoenix and blows it up, I just don't understand where he's going and what he wants to accomplish. Again, attacking these members and even disclosing that conversation, if it happened that way. Corker may have said, I'm wondering if I should run again. That doesn't mean he was asking the president of the United States if he should run again. And so you just worry about how he's trying to, I don't know what he's doing. He keeps doing this by subtraction. You know, politics is a game of addition, not subtraction. And President Trump just seems hell-bent to get that list of people that are with him as small as he can possibly get it.
Yeah, subtraction and maybe division as well, if we're talking about math here. All right, you're not just a former chairman inside the House of Representatives. You're also a big TV star. Declassified, which airs tomorrow night here on CNN at 9 p.m. An interesting episode this week about Cuba. Now, the United States not really at war with Cuba in any way right now. So why is there concern about spying?
Well, here's the thing about the Cubans, John, is really interesting. They are very good at it, and we forget that. They have excellent intelligence officers who do recruiting, put people in the right positions in the U.S. government to steal information. And then what the Cubans do is leverage that information with the Russians. They either sell it outright, get things for it, get arms deals, other things. So they use the information they steal as a commodity with their Russian friends. And so it's when you see a Cuban spy, guaranteed that our adversaries are getting access to that information, which is why that makes them such a dangerous adversary in the intelligence world.
Very interesting, especially during these times. Former Chairman Mike Rogers, thank you so much for being with us. Appreciate it. Declassified airs tomorrow night, 9 p.m. Eastern on CNN. Right now, we're just minutes away from a new update from the Hurricane Center on Harvey. We will find out if the storm has reached Category 3 status. We will also get a new forecast about just where it will make landfall and when. Stay with us.
Hello? No one asked us to go into the chaos.
Hello.
Into the heartbreak.
Welcome.
It's the story that drives us forward.
We have the memory.
a story that needs to be told. This is Why We Go.
Let's go live to CNN senior international correspondent Nima Elbakr.
Somebody to tell you their story, it's something I take really seriously, and it's not something you can just parachute in and ask somebody to open their heart to you. To peel away the layers to get to the heart of the person who you're telling a story about.
France will never give up against the terrorists.
And delve beneath the surface of what's happening. You can hear their story, and you're going to do their story justice. You have to show yourself to them.
How high was the water?
The water was as tall as that tree. CNN's the right place to tell their story.